At the Purdue Research Park, researchers in more than 200 companies are finding new ways to detect and treat illnesses like cancer, developing alternative fuels, fighting terrorism, healing wounds, exploring space. The idea economy is here. Tony Coiro, a Purdue University physics major from South Bend, Indiana, has developed a longtime love of transportation and energy. These interests led him to create a solar-powered motorcycle that may impact the manufacturing industry for years to come.
So actually, my grandpa had a car shop, so I grew up around cars. I've always had a fascination with transportation and automobiles. But as I learned more about physics, I began to realize that gasoline has some serious technical limitations. That's why I started looking into electric vehicles and the idea of converting a motorcycle to electric. It's a lot of fun, and it's really cool to see where it's going to go.
Tony purchased a 1978 Suzuki over the internet in September 2009. Over the next 8 months, he made several modifications to transform it to be powered by solar energy.
When you park it, the panels fold up perpendicular to the sun, and it starts charging. So the panels will absorb light, it goes, and then charges the batteries. The flow of current is controlled by a thing called the controller. It's the brain of the electric vehicle. This regulates power to the motor, and then the motor is attached to the rear wheel just via one gear and then a chain. There's no shifting, no clutch involved. So it's a much simpler system than gas vehicles. It's also much easier to ride because there's no shifting, no clutch.
The equipment Tony used to modify the motorcycle costs less than $2,500. He finished in April 2010, in time for the inaugural Purdue University Electric Vehicle Grand Prix, which he helped organize. He and his motorcycle have been a hit on campus and off.
It costs about 12 cents to charge off the grid. Obviously, solar would be free. And the range is about 16 to 24 miles. Obviously, the range is considerably more around the city than when I'm out in the country just messing around.
Tony's passion for motorcycles hasn't been sated with his work on modifying this vehicle to run on solar power. If anything, it has bolstered his interest to keep working on creating more efficient transportation.
Yeah, so I'm actually working on a new prototype right now. The new one should be right around 100 horsepower, well over 200 foot-pounds of torque, and 100 miles an hour as well. So it should be comparable, if not faster, than some of the gas bikes on campus. I think I should be able to get it done over the summer. So just a couple more months, I think. So some of it's already done. The motor's mounted. I've got the computer design's done. Now it's just a matter of finding time and getting to the shop and being able to get it done.
The next step in making Tony Coiro's solar-powered motorcycle available for the manufacturing industry includes developing it through the Purdue Research Foundation's Office of Technology Commercialization. Find out more by visiting PurdueResearchPark.com. The idea economy is here.